Hey guys, I'm Talia from Workweek Lunch. You might recognize me from Instagram at Workweek Lunch, and today I'm gonna get into everyone's favorite topic, meal prep containers. So I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know about the different kinds of meal prep containers, what I use and why, and how to make the best choices when you are shopping online for containers to put your yummy cooked food in. So let me tell you what you need to know. There are two main kinds of meal prep containers, glass and plastic. Now, I will tell you right now, obviously glass is going to be a more environmentally friendly choice because plastic is really hard to recycle and it just has a bigger impact on the earth. So for some people, it's an obvious choice that glass is way better. That being said, I use plastic more. And this is my favorite container. It's a lock and lock container, and we'll talk about this one more, but I use plastic because it's lighter. When I'm carrying these meals around in New York City in my backpack, it's just lighter in my bag with my laptop and everything else, and that's kind of the main reason why I use them. Also, they're less likely to break if you drop them. So those are the two main reasons why I like plastic. Of course, you know, these are reusable, so they're still not as bad as single-use plastic containers that you have to throw out right after you use them. That's what most takeout food comes in, right? These like plastic containers that you definitely can't reheat in the microwave. Speaking of the microwave, plastic containers that are meant for food are totally safe to put in the microwave. I will link to some articles below about this and why it's safe to use plastic in the microwave. Of course, if you are uncomfortable with that for whatever reason, you don't have to do it. I'm just telling you it's an option. So there are 7 different types of plastic, and I won't really go into that so much. I'll link below to an article about it, but most food containers have the number 5. They're the type of plastic of the number 5, and that means that they're safe to go in the microwave. If they're BPA free, that's great. They're totally fine. Your food won't taste like plastic. It's not gonna get onto your food. The only time that it becomes unsafe is if there's a scratch or a scrape or something in the plastic that kind of, that means that it's seen its day and it's time to part with it. Okay, so now I'm gonna tell you a little bit more about the specific containers I use and why. So I'm gonna just walk you through my meal prep containers one by one. Let's start with everyone's favorite, Pyrex. So this is a Pyrex dish. It's 3 cups, 700 milliliters. You can get these on Amazon. They're pretty cheap, and I really, really like them. They're easy to clean. They don't stain, they don't smell. They're nice and compact. They're totally clear. They photograph beautifully. One thing I don't like about them though is that these lids are not very leak proof. They don't snap, as you can see. They're just kind of like a lid, and they can potentially leak in your bag, which you definitely don't want. So if you are using these Pyrex glass 3-cup meal prep containers, I recommend putting them in a plastic bag or a lunchbox or something so that they're more contained, instead of just putting this right in your bag with everything else you own, because a soggy laptop is not an ideal situation. But I've been using these for a while and I really like them. My other favorite glass meal prep container are these meal prep containers from Meal Prep Society with a compartment, and I'll show you what they look like on the inside. So you can see there's 2 compartments in here. This divider doesn't go all the way to the top, so if this were to tilt, the foods would mix a little bit if they were liquid, so kind of watch out for that. You can get these on Amazon. I forget how much they were because I've had them for so long, and again, the glass containers last a long time. They're definitely heavier than the Pyrex ones. Like, I would not take this to work or class or on the go. They're something I would definitely want to reheat at home. So, and this one and the Pyrex one, totally oven safe. You can stick these right in the oven when you have your food in there, so you could reheat stuff in the oven too. So I really like these a lot. I almost like them more than the Pyrex ones because they have a snap top, which means they will not leak. Like, there's no way this thing is leaking in your bag. So this is definitely a better option if you're always on the go and you need glass containers that won't leak. So even if you don't get these ones from Meal Prep Society, get ones with a snap top so that it won't leak. So that's a really good one too. Now back to my favorite meal prep container from Lock & Lock. These are significantly lighter than the glass ones. And this is my favorite meal prep container size. It's 29 ounces, so that's about 2.5 or 2.9 cups of food. very similar to the Pyrex one in size, but I just love these squares. I find them to be really compact and easy to put food into. And they also have the snap top, like the glass one I just showed you. So these things are not leaking. You can put soup in here, you can put chili in here. It will not leak in your bag if you put them, you know, like this with your laptop and everything. I've done it, I've tested it. I would not steer you wrong. So I've had these for a while and I seriously love them. They don't stain. I've even had things with, you know, stained foods that are known to stain, like turmeric and tomato sauce, and they're still basically stain free. Like, obviously you can see that they've been used, but I wouldn't say that they're like they don't turn the color of the food that's in here. So I'm a huge fan of Lock and Lock. They have tons of sizes on Amazon, and full disclosure, I worked with them 2 years ago, so we're not currently working together, but I did work with them. That's why I have so many of these and I love them. So we've covered the main types of container, the clear glass and clear plastic types that most people use for meal prep. I also have with me this container, which is from Yumbox, and it's a cute little bento box. This is plastic. It's definitely more, I haven't used it yet, as you can see. It's definitely more durable than the Lock and Lock. It's kind of fun. I would probably, if I had kids, I would use this for my kids. This thing comes out, so you can actually just wash this and not worry about this guy. And you can see there's a little compartment in there, for like a circular compartment in there. And this one I would use for snacks, not really a whole meal. So there's that. I haven't used this one yet though. It has a snap lock too, so pretty leak proof. The last type of meal prep container I want to talk about today is stainless steel. So this one is from Lunchbots. It's a small one. I have ones that are larger in size, but they're currently in my dishwasher. And this is a snack bento box. So stainless steel is also more environmentally friendly than plastic, but you cannot put this in a microwave or an oven. So just note that this would be for like no reheat snacks or no reheat lunches or breakfasts or dinners. And that's the only catch to the stainless steel. I really like these though. I don't think they're leak proof, I don't think they're as leak proof as the other ones with the snap lock, but I haven't really tried too much. I usually put hummus and like chopped veggies in these things. So that's definitely an option. I got these on Amazon. All the stuff you can totally find on Amazon. There's different prices, different sizes. I would say if you are just starting fresh with meal prep containers and you've never purchased them before, you want like 5 to 10 meal prep containers, depending on how many meals that you're using and how often you do dishes, that are like around this 3 cup size. This is definitely the best size of meal prep container I've seen in terms of how much food satisfies me at a meal, but it could be different for you. So you might want to order a pack with different sizes so you can see which size of meal actually satisfies you. You should look to spend around $20 to $30 on a pack of meal prep containers. I wouldn't do anything where you're paying like $10 for one meal prep container. That's a little ridiculous, unless there's some fancy one with like whatever, I don't know, that comes with a heater in it, who knows. But I would say you're gonna end up spending anywhere from $15 to $35 on a pack of meal prep containers. I also want to say, if you are too intimidated by the options on Amazon, you can always go to your grocery store and pick up a package of Glad or Ziploc containers, the plastic ones, right in the aisle with all the like other Tupperware containers. Those are totally fine to start off with. No, they don't last as long. They do get scratched up pretty quickly and they are more likely to stain. But it's a good place for you to start if you're just starting with meal prep and you want to test the waters with portion size and also just getting used to taking your food to work or class every day. So there are lots of options for you, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you want to see more from me, I invite you to hit that subscribe button and the thumbs up button if you like this. And if you have any questions about meal prep containers, drop them in the comments. I will answer you. So thanks again, and I'll see you next time.